It's time to the prayer time, noon prayer time. Let's the reading the book of Mark of the Adult Bible Study Guide. This one is the third quarterly Bible booklet. It has 13 lessons. Today is the lesson 10. The book of Mark. I started last month, but it is really good. I studied this book during the 50 years, but just the reading lightly. But I wanna my hope to read every day on noontime or nighttime. But already passed. But I try to read on every day. So today, lesson 10, the last days. Read for this week's study, Mark 12, 41 through 44, and 13, 1 through 32, Daniel 9, 24 through 27, Daniel 7:25, 1 Thessalonians 4:13 through 18. A memory text. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And then he will send his angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the farthest part of earth to the farthest part of heaven. Mark 13:26 through 27. Yeah, this week's lesson starts with a very brief story at the end of Mark 12, where Jesus makes a profound statement about a small act by a widow. The main portion of this week's lesson, however, deals with Mark 13, a striking prophecy about the fate of the Jerusalem Temple and more. This chapter, along with its parallels in Matthew 24 and Luke 21, tell about the fall of Jerusalem and beyond, even to the end of the world. What Mark 13 makes quite clear is that the prophecy goes from the time of the prophet Jesus to the time of the end. His second coming, this pattern follows what is known as the historical interpretation of end-time prophecy, as opposed to the attempt to put these prophecies in the past or way off into the future. Like many teachings of Jesus in Mark, the Lord's instruction is in response to a question or a misunderstanding by his disciples. These questions or misunderstandings give Jesus the opportunity to teach truth vital to Christian life and experience. Jesus not only predicts the future, but also instructs his disciples both then and now is how to prepare for the coming trials. And there are Sunday parts. Yes, yesterday, today is the Monday, the Labor's Day, so there are holiday today. So yesterday we went to the outside with my grandkids. Two little coins in the offering. Read Mark 12, 41, 44 through 44. How much did the widow give, and what did Jesus have to say about that? The Jerusalem Temple was an amazingly beautiful structure. The Temple Mount dominated the city, and the massive stones involved in its construction are a marvel to this day. Some weighing hundreds of tons, the remodeling expansion of the temple and the Temple Mount began under Herod the Great around 20 BC. But construction and embellishment of the structure continued into the AD 60s. Many people brought large offerings to deposit in certain chests located in the court of the woman near the temple. It was here that Jesus was sitting when he saw a widow approach and cast in two leper. Two lepta. This would be equivalent to 1/30 second of a denarius. The user wage would be would user wage for a day laborer. Hence, the woman's offering was quite small. Jesus, however, was impressed by her offering. Many rich individuals put in large sums, but he did not comment on their gifts as they deposited them. But this widow's offering called forth his praise. He states that she gave more than everyone else. How is that possible? Jesus knows that they gave out of their abundance, but she, out of her poverty, they had much left. She gave everything she had to live on. This fact makes her gift extravagant. Even though its monetary value was tiny, this story contains a deep lesson about the management of resources. Giving to God's cause does not depend on the actions of leaders to have validity. The religious leadership of the temple was corrupt, but Jesus did not thereby affirm withholding offerings. If ever there were corrupt religious leaders, Caiaphas and us, those at this time were among the worst, and Jesus knew it too. It is true that leaders have a sacred responsibility to use resources in accordance with the will of God, but even if they do not, those who give to the cause of God are still blessed in their giving, as this woman was. On the other hand, withholding tithe or offerings when leaders do something displeasing means that the giving is tied to their actions. Instead of being made in thankfulness to God, however tempting it may be to do that, is wrong. What should this story teach us about the importance of being faithful in what we give to the Lord's work? I go to Monday, today, Monday, not one stone on another. Read Mark 13, 1 through 13. How did the disciples respond to Jesus' statement about the temple, and what is the significance of Jesus' answer to them? As we have noted, the temple, I'm sorry, I'll stop here, and I'm gonna read the Bible verse on Sunday's Bible verse 12, 41, 44, and I'll make the other video because of the 10 minutes limited. I'm just to limit the 10 minutes is better. So 12, 41 through 44 is 12, 41 through 44. Now Jesus sat opposite the treasury of and saw how the people put money into the treasury, and many too were rich, put in much. Then one poor widow came and threw in 2 mites, 2 mites, which make a quadrants. So he called his disciples to him and said to them, "Assuredly, I say to you that this poor widow has put in more than all those who have given to the treasury, for they all put in out of their abundance, but she, out of her poverty, put in all that she had, her whole livelihood." For whole livelihood, yeah. Thank you, yeah. Now, let's pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Yeah, the first time when I started this, the prayer, noontime prayer, I wanna divide each, the day one, Sunday, Monday part. This one is, all the part, separate all the part. So I try to, if the during the I since I started reading this lesson study, I read the whole lessons. It takes maybe 40 minutes like that. The first time almost 1 hour, and next time I try to read faster than the 30 minutes or 40 minutes. 30 minutes around, but I read also the inside story, so I added the 10 minutes more. But now I gonna divide the 10 minutes. Every day is better. Yeah, so that's why I gonna keep this, rule to myself. So yeah, may God bless all of you. I mean, it works. It's good. I just read one more time memory text, one more time, Bible, same verses. But it's good to just to reading. I gonna I can remind them when I just reading the word Korean and English too. So why don't you try? Let's go together. Yeah, may God bless all of you. Amen. Yes.